Next, state true or false. A. To check the congruency of a plane figures, superimposition method can be used. That is true. What is superimposition? See, this is superimposition. You put one thing on another to check whether they are exactly matching with each other. They are used in all the sciences, mathematical sciences plus archaeological, in statistics, graphics, everything they are used. So if two triangles are put over each other and they match exactly, then they are congruent. That's the way. Okay? So that's why it is true. Next. Two segments with different lengths can be congruent. That's false. Say this. AB and BC. These are two segments. Are they congruent? Different lengths. Not congruent. The measures of two congruent angles is always the same. That's true. See this. These two angles, G and S. They can be put in any direction, but if the measures are equal, they are congruent. Objects which are exactly same are plane objects. That is false. See these two cubes. They are exactly same, but are they congruent? No. Are they plane figures? No, because these are solid objects. Your two hands, they are exactly same, but are they plane figures? No, they are solid objects. If all the corresponding angles in two triangles are congruent, then the triangles are congruent. False. See, these two angles, ABC and XYZ, all the angles are congruent. But are the angles congruent, triangles congruent? No, they are similar. This is a test for similarity. For congruency, there are only these five tests, SAS, SSS, SAS, ASA, AAS and RHS. These are the only five tests. Which of the following triangles are